Hello students, welcome to the session. As we all know, tuberculosis, mainly it attacks our lungs, but here is a condition called as intestinal tuberculosis. There are nearly three forms of intestinal tuberculosis: primary, secondary and hyperplastic cecal tuberculosis. Primary tuberculosis of the ileocecal region is quite common in developing countries, including India. This is mainly due to ingestion of unpasteurized cow's milk, which is rich in Mycobacterium bovis. In the pre-pasteurization era, it used to occur by ingestion of unpasteurized cow milk. Grossly, the affected lymph nodes are enlarged, matted, and caseous. There is a healing by fibrosis and calcification. Microscopically, in the initial stage, there is primary complex, or also called as Gans focus, tuberculosis granulomatous inflammatory reaction with caseous necrosis. Tuberculosis peritonitis may also occur. In case of secondary intestinal tuberculosis, self-swallowing of sputum in patients with active pulmonary tuberculosis may cause secondary intestinal tuberculosis, most commonly in the terminal ileum and rarely seen in the colon. Grossly, the intestinal lesions are prominent than the lesions in regional lymph nodes, as in secondary pulmonary tuberculosis. Histologically, presence of tubercles, mucosa and submucosa show ulceration, and the muscularis may be replaced by variable degree of fibrosis. Tuberculosis peritonitis may be seen here. Hyperplastic cecal tuberculosis, grossly the cecum or ascending colon are thick walled with mucosa, ulceration. Clinically, the lesion is palpable and may be mistaken for carcinoma. Microscopically, the presence of caseating tubercles will be seen. There is one more condition called as enteric fever or typhoid ulcer. The term enteric fever is used to describe acute infection caused by Salmonella typhi, or also called as Salmonella paratypi. Means whenever Salmonella typhi infection is there, it's called as typhoid fever, or Salmonella paratypi, it's called as paratyphoid fever. Salmonella typhi murium causes food poisoning. Pathogenesis: the typhoid bacilli are ingested through contaminated food or water. During the initial asymptomatic incubation period of about 2 weeks, the bacilli invade the lymphoid follicles and pairs patches of the small intestine and proliferate there. Following this, the bacilli invade the bloodstream, causing bacteremia, and the characteristic clinical features of the disease like continuous rise in temperature and rose spots on the skin are observed. The bacilli are localized in the intestinal lymphoid tissue, producing typhoid intestinal lesions in the mesenteric lymph nodes, hemorrhagic lymphadenitis, liver parenchymal necrosis, gallbladder, typhoid cholecystitis, spleen, splenic reactive hyperplasia, kidneys, nephritis, joints, arthritis, bones, osteitis, meninges, meningitis, testis, orchitis. Morphological features: the lesions are observed in the intestines as well as in other organs of the body. Intestinal lesions, grossly terminal ileum is affected most often, but lesions may be seen in the jejunum and colon. Pairs patches shows oval typhoid ulcers. The base of the ulcers is black due to sloughed mucosa. The margins of the ulcers are slightly raised due to inflammatory edema and cellular proliferation. No fibrosis, but regional lymph nodes are invariably enlarged. Microscopically, there is hyperemia, edema and cellular proliferation consisting of phagocytic histiocytes, lymphocytes, and plasma cells. Though enteric fever is an example of acute inflammation, neutrophils are invariably absent. Small intestinal tumors are also called as carcinoid tumors, are also called as argentophyoma. Argentophyoma is a generic term applied to tumors originating from endocrine cells. Argentophyoma are Kolchitsky cells, belonging to APUD cell system, and are therefore also called as apodomas. Midgut carcinoids seen in terminal ileum and appendix are the most common site, nearly 60 to 80%. Ingut carcinoids occurring in rectum and colon and comprise about 10 to 20% of the carcinoids. Foregut carcinoids located in the stomach, duodenum and esophagus. Other uncommon locations are the bronchus, trachea, gallbladder and Meckel's diverticulum. Appendix and terminal ileum, common sites for carcinoids. Appendiceal carcinoids occur more frequently in third and fourth decades of the life, behave as local malignant tumors. Ileal carcinoids, on the other hand, are seen more often in later ages, at 70 or 7th decade, with female predominance, are more commonly multiple and behave like metastatic carcinomas. Morphological features. Grossly, all carcinoids are small button-like submucosal elevations with intact or ulcerated overlying mucosa. They are usually small, though larger than 2 cm, and more often metastasizing. Ileal and gastric carcinoids are commonly multiple, whereas appendiceal carcinoids commonly involve the tip of the organ and are solitary. Cut section of all the carcinoid is bright yellow in color. Histologically, the tumor cells may be arranged in a variety of patterns: solid, nests, sheets, cards, trabecule and clusters, all of which show characteristic palisading of the peripheral cells. The tumor cells are classically small, having uniform nuclei and poorly defined cell boundaries. The argentophyne carcinoids show eosinophilic granules in the cytoplasm, which stain positively by the argentophyne reactions. Mitotic figures are very rare.